Hey guys, welcome back to Let's Play Civilizations Beyond Earth. Polar difficulty, playing as African Union. I'm Logiboy123, and we're on the tail end of this game with high strength by a very long way. Just waiting for the tactical lev to complete, then we can build our Exodus Gate, and I guess we'll just start. We've just declared peace. We've just gotten peace with Kavitha, so we'll just start loading up some of these buildings with science and culture. Food. And yeah, you can do with a water refinery. That's about it. We'll leave that on there. Don't really need this. You can build another trade vessel and biofuel and optimal stewardry and no pasture. Why not? Well, see, we'll build one of everything in this city. No reason not to. Why? I thought we were building okay. What is it doing? Why does it do that? God, that's freaking annoying. We already have the quest from this, so there's no point in building that one. I believe we already have this. And I don't think we have this, so I'll just get it as well. See how we're going from there. We'll go for more food so we can get to level 20 and then get another trade route. Yeah, not really much more to do this game. We've pretty much got it in the bag. Can't really lose this now. So I'm just gonna move these troops. So there's like one troop per city. I'll keep constructing, you know, some terrascapes and a few things here and there. But we need to start planning for. I'll leave these guys up the front lines. Battle suits and the lead tanks. I shall bring this guy back up. She might attack, actually. She probably will attack, actually. So, let's plan to deal with that. Can't do anything with our ships, but actually, you know what? When they're finished healing, I'll send them to auto explore. But we'll bring these guys down to here. Same. Excuse me. Yeah. Might as well pick up some of the cooler wonders, especially in cities where we've already got all the other stuff that we need, or we can, got all the stuff that we can build. Civilizations Beyond Earth is definitely an easier game to play than Civilizations 5, I think anyway. This is a lot easier for me to finish than Civilizations 5. So actually, we do want the crawler, because the Exodus gate is coming up soon, so is this the right place to build it though? 80? Yeah, probably. Good grief. 80. Who's the 100. Wow, okay. 80. So we're definitely going to build the Exodus gate. Excuse me, reset that. Definitely building the Exodus gate here. For sure. Can talk to you and take some of your energy. Sounds like a good plan to me. 20. Take 20. Yeah. Cool. And 6. Yep, sweet. You take your minus 88. Nice. Minus 31. Minus 14. Why are they? Because they've got too many troops. That's why. Minus 48. Okay, so you're all impoverished. Fine. We should win anyway when that happens. Completely forgot to set my timer. Just do that now. Daedalus ladder. Yep, that's good. It gives us plus 10 on everything.
Beyond this flesh.
Plus 10% on everything. Thank you. Oh, we can't actually start building our Exodus gate for two turns because this guy's still building a nano pasture. Maybe we could just buy it. Be a bit of a waste of money, but excuse me. Oh, are you serious? Flippin' egg. Really? Okay. So, we'll pick up the other ones anyway. Don't need that. Don't need that. We'll buy that. And nano pasture. Oh, we'll just buy it. It'll speed up in the game by one turn. Okay, so pretty sure when the troops come through, you have to have like four distance between you and where they're going, so 1, 2, 3, 4, he is good. So I just gotta build a mag rail there. Doesn't matter. Excuse me. Whole family's a bit sick at the moment. I can't remember what the distance between them has got to be, but let's just say we're going to put one over here somewhere. So we need to go from here, the mag rail. Let's just assume we're going to put one here, maybe one right, 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe one there. Not sure. We'll see how it goes. See what the rules say. Might as well just try and get a max out our purity. Ah, that's the other thing. We've got to start. Yeah. Yeah, we bring them here. Connection issue. Okay. Haven't seen that before. I'm just really cruising now, killing time until we get to the point where we have success. It's hard to imagine we could lose the game now, right? But you never know. Might happen. Don't think so, but just leave you as you are. Need a trade vessel. Ooh, okay.
Open your eyes.
Just looking for the highest, the best trade route. Check this and see what's going on. Don't know why it's doing that. got about 20 more turns left in the game. Once we get this gate, we start bringing people through and we start settling them on our planet. Takes about 10 more turns after that, but after that we're pretty much done. So, yeah, game's a bit one-dimensional. It really needs to... really needs to be able to allow people to play how they want. If you want to play tall, you should be allowed to play tall. If you want to play wide, you should be able to play wide, but it should give you options. At the moment, this whole... excuse me. It doesn't give you the option. It doesn't give you an option. You really just have to play wide in this game. Which is unfortunate, because it's a really good game. I mean, the premise is great, right? Wish you could fast forward. One of the annoying things about this game is the end. Like, you build something, a gateway, a mind flower thing or something. Everyone else learns that you've done it, and now they've got like 20 or 30 turns to try and kill you. It's kind of, I don't know. I'm not sure I like that aspect of this game. Certainly, it'd be very hard to win by stealth. It'd be very hard to win by stealth, I think. So, I feel like actually just telling all my workers to go on pause and go next, 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 next. Literally, that's what I feel like doing, because I'm getting tired of micromanaging all these minions. I mean, it's fantastic having them, and they're all free, allegedly, because of my wonder, but, yes. Just fortify. Actually, you can build a terrascape. Actually, that's one of the good things about building a terrascape. Like, it takes a lot of turns to build one, so it's kind of not a problem. Yeah, condemn away. Attack me if you want. See how far you get. I think, from memory, one of the annoying things about the Exodus to gate is you have to click on it. You have to remember to click on it every turn and say, bring a dude here. Sort of thing from Earth.
John Henry Smut.
And that's some ideas. I always thought that was really frustrating because if you forgot, you know, you could potentially lose a game based on two or three turns, quite honestly. Exit escape. Pretty sure you get a person. You send them at least four tiles away, and then you can build like a settlement, which looks like a city, and then you can shove like four people there, and you got to do this for like 10 people or something. So you got to summon Earth Settler. Really? Okay. That seems like a really strange wonder. But hey, why not? Build science. Now, can it be found in Israel within three tiles of another city, outpost of Earth and so on, or along the edge of the map? So within three tiles, 1, 2, 3. So I was right. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we can go here. Tell all my workers to build a terrascape now. So, one's there. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we can build another one here. Build another one. 1, 2, 3, 4. You build another one here. And it's already roaded up. You build one here. And... Route 2. You could build one here and one here. Just build. And then just build food, mate. Levels, whatever they are. Petrochemical, blah, and then just build food. Don't harass me again. Build science. So this guy is going here. How do you... just delete, put you there, come here. Why can't I? Excuse me. Ah, bugger. I think the reason I couldn't pop a colonist there was because I had a worker there who was trying to build a road on top of this. I forgot that when you place this, you should really put it on top of a road, otherwise it starts out roadless. So the first turn your unit takes forever. So we'll move here. Really? I should have put it there. Potentially put one here as well. But how many do we need? We need 10 colonists, isn't it? It's 10 colonists, isn't it? I thought that's what it was. Should mean you should be able to do it over two. Oh man, I can't remember. Right, these guys can really hammer out a terrace cap real fast now. Six turns. Wow, that's really fast. So there's a mag rail there now. Sweet. Yeah, you need to put this on top of a mag rail that already exists, so that as soon as the colonist comes through, they can just go wham, wham, sort of thing. Should have a mag rail on top of that as well. But it's not really a big deal because I can just join this guy there. I'll just finish this one first. That's big deal. You know what, I'm just going to delete any worker that runs out of work to do. I'm just going to delete it. Oh, it's 20. Okay, so we're going to need 20 divided by 6 is 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And this guy can come here. This guy needs to go there. No. Could go there. Wow, okay, what are you doing? Doesn't really matter where he goes at this point in time. Just doesn't matter. Oh, what did I just do? Thank you. So yeah, just pulling colonists through every turn. I need 20 of them. So that's basically one settlement, two settlement, three settlement, four settlement. Start moving these ones up to here because you want your last one to just go straight from here to here and then bang, you end it on the same turn that you pull it through. If you build all of this out first and then it's all this out second, then by the time the last one comes through, the 20th one comes through, you got to send it two or three turns up some road to actually finish the game. And sometimes one or two turns can mean the difference between you winning and you losing. So why take the risk? Just be efficient about it, that's all. Not that I'm always efficient, but there you go. Why did I even build that there? That's madness. Whatever. Did I pick up a colonist? Oh god, I hate that. You, what we might do is grab the next two cellists, send them over here straight away for two there, six here, six there, and then the last one will go here. God, all this is just such a waste of time now. It's like, why do I need to keep doing this? I guess if you were playing against humans, you would definitely be keeping a close eye on it, because if you didn't, they would all kill you because you're so close to victory. So in theory, 12 more turns, and then this game is finished. You could potentially skip ahead if you wanted to. seeing if the phasal transporter actually works, because you could potentially pick someone up from here, drop them here in one turn. But it's actually more efficient to run one of these guys to here and then build a city. Wonder if you get a turn out of it. I've never used one before, so we'll put one up. We'll put it over here, yeah. And we'll test it and see how it works. Okay, so how does it work? Move. No? Okay. How does it... Ah, oh, are you serious? Maybe you need one here and there. Probably just take this one and put him there. Really? Okay. Maybe you can't use it on those guys. Health, that's not bad. Okay, how do you use this thing? How do you use a phasal transporter? Good grief, okay, fine. That's fine. Ten, 11 more turns anyway. It doesn't really matter if I do that or not, but it just keeps her off her back, so it's fine. I should actually, in theory, I should have some trade routes going to the other major powers, just to keep them, you know, Diplo kind of having
to
attack me at the last
minute. I remember, but we...
No, don't do that. So this one's full. This one will be full in a minute. That's one there. I need another one there, and then the rest of them will all go there. Okay, so six there, six there, one more there, and then four more here. So four more turns, five more turns, and then we finish the game. Sure, I don't really care. Sure, why not? Let's do it. Doesn't really matter what we build now. Doesn't really matter what we, what our spies do now. Honestly, it doesn't matter. Oh, we're about to, well, we'll just keep playing, obviously. Because we've only got about three or four turns to go. Two more turns, I think. It should be two more turns, and then we are victorious. Wouldn't that be nice? Go away. Excavations. I haven't excavated anything in a long time. I have no idea what that's about. Last turn. Should be anyway. 6, 6 is 12. Well, 6 is 18. Plus 2. Yeah. Ooh, they're getting angry now. Anyway, thanks for joining me. If you watched from the start of the series, I really appreciate it. Thanks. If you put some likes on there, that'd be really good too. Yeah, thanks for joining me for this session. It was lots of fun. I don't know if I want to do another one. I may, but it's a little bit one-dimensional, this game at the moment, and there's only really one... As far as I can tell, there's only really one way to play, and that's wide. You can do that various ways, but you have to go wide, and you have to get a lot of cities as quickly as possible and develop them, and you will be behind because it's Apollo, right? And they get all sorts of advantages. But you're behind, and you've got to try and figure out a way to get ahead, whether it's militarily or science or whatever. Trade isn't an option anymore because it was nerfed so heavily. I mean, it's still really strong. If you pick up the right abilities and the right skills, then it works fine. Ta-da! We win. Thanks for joining me. I'm LogicBoy123, and I appreciate you following me. Cheers.